Okay, do you have specific questions that you ask?
Exactly what you asked.
Exactly what I asked. Okay, I'm curious, what was the learnings that you took away from today's session, either from experiencing some rather challenging mishaps on my end in the beginning, or watching or participating in one of the role plays? And for this, I would love for you to just write like one word or a couple words in the chat, and then I'll pick some to elaborate. So I'll give you a moment to just write something, some learning that you had, and then yes, we can hear from everyone. Just want to give you a moment to write something down first. Okay. Thanks for sharing those in the chat. Who would like to start us off and just elaborate a bit on what you wrote in the chat? And just to make sure that we are able to get through everyone, keep it to like 30 seconds or 40 seconds, between 30 and 40 seconds. Dove.
Immersive view, verbal aikido, and that's it.
What about immersive view and verbal aikido? You still have a
Immersive
few
view is a
seconds.
tool that I have to play with, and verbal aikido is putting words on a behavior that I love, meaning that using their force instead of resisting it is a thing, is a verbal thing.
I can go next.
Thank you.
For me,
Okay.
it was the impact of role play that I've actually ignored for a long time and neglected how easy it is to take on an extreme view and to then brainstorm together on the solutions and what to do about it. I found this very inspiring.
Nice.
Yeah, for me, the fact about thinking worst negative worst scenario helped to be creative and find a positive solution, be an inspiration about the solutions.
Nice.
Yeah, it was similar for me. That also wowed me how it evolved then in the chat, how the things were also somehow building onto each other. And for me, one big takeaway out of all that is there's actually nothing to be afraid about because at the end of the day, people are responsible for their experience. It's not you that's responsible for their feelings or for their behavior.
Great point.
Something I
Yona?
learned
Or, yeah.
was how you created a safe space for yourself. By doing the community agreement, you ask permission for failure and for experimentation. So all of us, or rather, maybe I'll just speak for myself, a bit more in a playful mood, willing to accept things that could go wrong.
Something we talked about in the podcast, right, Miriam?
Very well done.
Kate?
About you, Jan? Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, just to build on what everybody else said, I've seen, like dark side, light side exercises before. Seldom have they been as effective as this was because of the role play. So I found the role play really fired up people's creativity in a great way. And there was something else, but I forget. So there you go.
Did everybody else go? Right? Yeah. For me, yes, the role play was definitely the part that I was the most excited about this. And especially the part of when doing role playing, asking everyone else to participate in finding the strategies. I feel like that makes role playing much more accessible. because I would never be the one to volunteer. But looking at all of the suggestions that you would get in the chat when the group collaborates, I feel like you feel supported to do something that is uncomfortable. And to me, that's the whole idea of creating that brave space of like, okay, we're going to do something uncomfortable, but you're not going to have to do it by yourself. We're going to support you and we're going to debrief and you're going to learn something. And just the what Jonas said, the community agreements, I just today, last minute, added a few more things in there because I realized that that's really important so you don't feel upset with me manipulating you. So if I get you to agree beforehand, then I will feel a little bit better about doing it. If I didn't do that, I probably would have broken some of my own values.
Yeah. So overall, Jan, thank you so much for this great, inspiring, insightful experience. So thank you. And the way how you guided us was a big learning, I think, for all of us. And we could all learn from each other.
Nice. The one last thing I want to share as a tip, which you can look up on my YouTube channel. I'm actually going to share a link to a video in the chat, which I called the Emergency Breakout Room, which has become my go-to when things go wrong and I don't know what to do, is send everyone to a breakout room. If there's like one, and we talked about this earlier, like one person that is causing trouble, leave them out so you can have your one-on-one conversation, but the rest of your participants have no idea. Yeah, I use that often when fire alarms go off, as you will see in the video, when my son comes in and like needs something that I can't just work out in like a couple of seconds. So check out that video as just a good thing to have in your back pocket. When things go wrong, just make up your breakout room activity. Debrief whatever you just talked about. Like, what did you learn in the last 30 minutes? Go to a breakout room with a partner and share. Works every time.
Awesome. Thank you for sharing. Thank you for joining. See you next week.
Nice. Thanks, everyone.
Thanks, everyone. That was great.